Hello everyone, Achain over here. As you always know, if you like my videos, you can like them and also subscribe if you like Solo the Rogue in general in one of the casts that is in a corner somewhere. So let's begin this video. This is going to be a short one because there has been some interesting things. We have found a new build. Well, it was found the other day, but I actually didn't kind of see it with our new gear. You can check also the guide on Wohead. It has other alternative builds to this one, but this one at least, it's the one that seems higher for me and many others. You can also check. I'm going to kind of explain a little bit how to play with the first dance and equine reprimand to the fast. You can check my video for general usage, and when the ride comes closer, I will make a longer one with, in this case, as you might expect, banish timings and cooldown usage in general. It's going to be kind of in-depth. If you want a really fast rundown, you banish between the first two dances, then at 1 minute, then at 3 minutes and a half or something, and then at 5 minutes and a half. And then if the fight is 6 minutes or something, you get another banish that you just use and use all your cooldowns before the boss dies. And if it's longer, I will have to see, because right now Ferak, we don't know if it's a super epic 50 minute fight or just a like Sarkareth, just go and kill it in like 6 or 7 minutes. So, to the thing that's important right now and what you want to know, let's talk about first dance and equine reprimand with our new build. This is not the build to play for the tier when we have the new tier set, but it's the one that we will play while we get the new 4 set. Even with when we have the new 2 set, this thing will not change. So let's begin. As you all know, we are playing the Rotten. Why are we playing the Rotten? I already explained it in the other video, but it's because our tier set gives us 3 symbols of death. So that gives us, every time we dance, 2 stacks of the Rotten, increasing the damage of our builder and making them crit 100% of the time. Of course, this means that Equine Reprimand and in Shadow Strike are the ones that we want to use it, or 2 Shadow Strikes, it's fine, because Equine Reprimand, we will try to use it inside dance, but if you can't, there's no problem, you use it on cooldown. If you have just used the dance, it's not worth to wait until you have a dance again. It's not like Cold Blood, where you have to just macro it and you can just wait. Equine Reprimand, you just keep using it. There will be some situations where you will want to wait a little bit to get symbols, dance and other things before banishing, but that's something that I will explain in the cooldowns focused video. This one's really easy. Another trick, before pull, 15 seconds, you press Symbols of Death and you still get 2 stacks of your Rotten. I also, because this is on live, I need to change one bint. So now I have my Equine Reprimand in my bars because I didn't. And now, of course, you would hit the boss when you have 10 seconds here, it's fine, but you kind of want to do it earlier. So if you can get a 20 second pull from your raid leader, it will be perfect for us. And you will use your Symbols of Death and then wait. And of course, when it gets to zero, don't pre-pull because you're going to die. You will use your... This will be a little different than the one I had shown before. We are going to do Shadow Strike, Flagellation, and then a Slice and Dice, because we don't play Premeditation right now with this build. So we need that Slice and Dice as soon as possible, and then we will use Dance and Echoing Reprimand with Blades and Symbols of Death. Why we do that? Because we will fill combo points anyway, so might as well get some damage, and also that way we don't miss one Shadow Technique that will be wasted with using the Equine Reprimand and not getting to 7, because we will get to 6 and then we will use one of those points that we will need to get another free finisher with Shadowcraft. So let's do it really, really fast. Remember, don't look at numbers or anything. You can look here at my the timings of my abilities. It is going to be really, really easy. I'm only going to do these first things because, as I already told you, I'm going to do a full video about dances and things elsewhere. And now, when we have 10... Sí. Really, really easy. Here you see I messed up because I didn't use the pre-finishers that we got. As you can see, you get some pre-finishers all the time. Of course, if you have the Dragonfire Bomb Dispenser, remember to use it. And it's really, really easy. Also, one thing I forgot on the first dance, you use at least one backstab inside of your dance while you have blades. So, that will be the fast rundown, and I will see you on the next video.